I set it up because I recognised the desperate plight of children that were very, very ill and who hadn't got the wealth or ability to help themselves, cure themselves. And so we set the charity up with the express intention of helping any child with any major, major medical illness or serious disability, and try the aim being to try and make their lives better and to the point of the most rehabilitation that we could achieve. There's hundreds of thousands of disabled children in the UK, and there's tens of thousands more every year, ranging from autism to type 2 muscular atrophy, all sorts of challenges for parents. And often there's no medical help. You know, it's a tragedy in a Western society that we have children that are born with, say, for instance, type 2 muscular atrophy, who absolutely desperately need equipment like a wheelchair. The wheelchair transforms their life. Without it, they're really, really incredibly challenged. I mean, they're incredibly challenged with it. But as you'll see tonight, there's children here who are leading relatively full lives, or you could say totally full lives, as a result of what the wheelchair does for them. But the health service don't supply it. Nobody supplies it. So if charities like us don't step up and take this responsibility, it doesn't happen. And those children's lives remain devastated forever. And they end up with a massively reduced quality of life compared to that they could have with the wheelchair. Well, the work that we do is transformative in many, many, many ways. SDR operations that converted Susie, helped her with her cerebral palsy and enabled her to walk, and she's now undergoing physiotherapy and is now walking up the purple carpet. She couldn't have done that before. Jay down there in the wheelchair, who is actually an employee of Caudwell Children now, and we started helping her, I think, when she was about 17. Type 2 muscular atrophy again, and as a consequence of supplying her the wheelchair, she was able to go to university, able to drive a car, able to transport herself about, did a master's degree, and then after qualifying applied for a job with Caudwell Children, applied for a job against hundreds of other applicants, and gained the position. And that's just phenomenal to see. Well, the butterfly ball was named that way because little Tilly, who when she was about 6 or 7, realised the significance of what we'd done for her. Tilly had type 2 muscular atrophy, she was in a wheelchair, and she did this collage of little butterflies. And at the bottom of the collage were butterflies that were weedy, shriveled up little butterflies. She put a line on the collage, and then these massively beautiful butterflies, bright colours, big wings, flying off into the sunset. And these butterflies that were so beautiful were above the line, and the line was named Caudwell Children. And so hence, you know, as a consequence of auctioning off that that lot that year, that beautiful collage, we named it the Butterfly Ball. Just go to the Caudwell Children website, it's very easily found, and you know, we're very grateful for any help we can get, ranging from volunteers, trustees, ambassadors, right the way through, of course, to financial donations.
What is the importance, the vital importance of charities like Caudwell Children?
Well, first of all, every penny raised goes to helping a disabled child. This is such a key thing because a lot of times, you know, with charities, people, when they go to give, they want to know where the money's going. You see it here. I've met the families. I've seen what the effect that they have on not just the children but the parents. So it doesn't just help the child. It's a knock-on effect. It's a great charity. And to be honest, when you look into it, you will see what I mean. It's great.
As a parent yourself, do you see the transformative effect that this charity's work has as something truly miraculous?
It really is. I mean, you know, some of the people, actually one of the girls that works for Caudwell is actually on one of the wheelchairs that Caudwell have supplied where she can stand. You know, imagine when you're in a wheelchair, to be able to stand and be on the same level as dad or mum or your brothers or I mean, these are incredible things, and all the money that's raised funds these things. So, you know, you see the difference. And then again, the knock-on effect it has on the people around them. I'm just, honestly, I'm so grateful I'm busy. I've got lots of things coming up. Do I mention them, or is this the right place?
Yeah, you can.
I don't want to bore you with all the details, but there's a lot.
Want to be bored. The fans want to be bored. What have you got coming?
I've just did a link with Australia last night, so we've just announced our first tour in 20 years, which is huge. I'm going off to America to meet some film directors in August, so lots coming up. I just want to drag my whole family with me.
Fantastic to have you back with us at the Butterfly Ball. I know you're a long-term supporter of the charity. Can you talk a little bit about why it has such a special place in your heart?
Well, I think it's because it takes care of kids so well. Kids that are, you know, going through hard times maybe. And they're very well looked after and given some great help and aids, you know, whether they need a wheelchair or, you know, whatever help they need, they seem to get it from Caudwell Kids, which is fantastic.
You describe the emotions you feel when you see young people here tonight who've had their lives transformed by the support the charity provides for them.
Well, the emotion is just part of the evening, you know, tears, emotion, whatever it is. You know, just see the kids battling whatever, you know, illness they've got and see them come out fighting with it, always with a big smile on their faces. And it's just a humbling evening, really.
And obviously, given the challenging times we live in, is it particularly nice to see beautiful evenings like tonight?
Well, that is one of the lovely things, to see everybody putting their posh rocks on and their nice suits and seeing all the kids, you know, in their wheelchairs and getting their best frock on and stuff. It's just a really brilliant night. I've got a film coming out called Dark River with Sean Bean and some other people out of Game of Thrones and things. You know, I'm doing a little bit of singing and things and a lot of voiceovers, so everything's all right, ticking along.
Tell us anything about that film you've done with Sean, what that's about or who you're playing.
It's about a family that have gone through some hard times, I would say, without giving the game away. Maybe not nice hard times. So it's a daughter-father thing as much as anything.
What was it like working with Sean?
Yeah, well, we're both from the same area, both blokey blokes, so, yeah, it was all right. We could understand each other anyway, that was the main thing.
That's always helpful. And were you trying to stay away from him on set, though? Because, obviously, he always gets killed off, so you probably don't want to be standing too near him most of the time.
Well, I didn't want to stand too near him because he's a Sheffield United fan. But, you know, hey, football's big in Yorkshire. What can I say?
What is the importance of charities like Caudwell Children that support disabled children and their families?
Well, I think any children's charity for a kid is so important. I mean, I'm a granny at 10, so for me, I really want to support anything for children, especially disabled children. You know, they need some support and they need a lot of love.
You're excited about tonight. How did you find out about the event? What brought you along?
I am excited, yes. I think it'd be really lovely. I've not been here before, so this is my first time, so I'm looking forward to it. It should be great.
When you're not supporting this wonderful cause, what have you got coming up yourself at the moment?
Oh, I've been busy working on my organic products, so I've got a new salt scrub and body wash coming out in October.
Why is staying organic so important for you?
I really truly believe it's the best thing you can do for your body and what you put on your skin. I think we need to have organic products. Every woman needs an organic product, yes, and organic food.
Do you think there's enough government support for organic products? Do you think there should be more done to encourage going for organic?
Yeah, I definitely think it should be encouraged in hospitals for children. I think that's really important to feed a child a really nutritious, healthy food for recovery. Anybody goes to hospital, especially children, and I think it should be in schools as well.
Oh, it's massively important, isn't it? It's like we you know, children and I think, you know, I have children myself, so I love doing stuff like this, and if you can give a little bit back in the world with the way that it is right now, then you know, I feel privileged to even be here to be a part of it.
How did you find out about Caudwell Children and the Butterfly Ball tonight?
I'm friends with a few people that actually have put the event on and have a table, and I was invited tonight, so me and Jamie came down and decided to actually be a part of it, which is great.
My final question, when you're not supporting wonderful causes like this, what have you got coming up yourself at the moment? Always a busy man.
Just working on EastEnders at the moment, so that's the new thing that I'm doing for the next year. So I'm going to be head into scripts and learning and being on set, so I'm looking forward to that.
Well, yeah, 50 year on the bounce coming to the event itself specifically, but being an ambassador for a charity that I've seen personally from John put so much into himself and the results from the children, which a lot of who are going to be on stage tonight, it's just such a great charity that gives such support, but not only financially for the medical side of things, but emotionally, and that really comes through on the videos that we see on these nights. So I'm looking forward to seeing some positive stories and seeing how much we can raise again.
For people who aren't familiar with the specific work that the charity does, can you talk a little bit as an ambassador about exactly where the money goes when it's raised at nights like tonight?
Yeah, so what John does, which is quite different to a lot of other charities, John Caudwell, is matches all of the costs. So every single pound that gets donated at an event like tonight goes directly to both medical and emotional support for these, both the families and actually the kids themselves. So whether it's an electric wheelchair or whether it's the support for the family to get that kid through that process as well, I think it's such an all-round benefit, not just the actual support of being in the hospital bed, for instance.
Do you think that perhaps people sometimes underestimate the extent to which this affects people? Because obviously there are literally hundreds of thousands of families in the UK who rely very much on this daily support.
Yeah, it can be massively underestimated. And some of these kids put such a brave face on, and it's very hard to even ask for help, that it takes charities like Caudwell Kids or people like John himself to step up and do this. And it's such an incredible feat of what's been done in previous years. I can't believe how much was raised last year, but if we get anywhere near that tonight, that'll be amazing. So I'm really looking forward to it. Yeah, well, the Le Mans 24 Hour is the week after next. So training and preparations for the race season. We've had a couple of races so far this year, won the last one. So, looking forward to a busy year of motor racing.
How confident are you about Le Mans this time?
This time, good. We've got Nismo Nissan backing, so we've got a strong engine. So we're one of the top five favourites to win.
And obviously, it's been an interesting time for motorsport fans with Fernando Alonso. He's going to be tackling Indy. How do you feel about that, seeing another high-profile F1 driver trying to make the transition?
Amazing. I was just in London last weekend commentating for BT Sport on Fernando doing quali, and what he's done has just been absolutely incredible. To jump in completely in new chartered territory and be qualifying in the top nine straight away and end up fifth, I think it'll be pretty damn amazing if he wins.
Do you think that Le Mans could mean his future as well? Because I think the Triple Crown is being talked about in quite excited and hushed tones.
Yeah, I think he's already in talks with a few people, so that's definitely something on his horizon. It'd be great to be his teammate for it.
I guess my final question, obviously, amongst motorsport, Le Mans has a mystique, a certain presence. What do you think makes it, for many people, the pinnacle of motorsport as a race?
I think because the cars now are as quick as Formula One cars, certainly on race pace, and you've got the names coming in, ex-Formula One and current Formula One guys, and obviously people like Alonso looking to go into it. These cars are not only technically some of the most complicated in the world and fastest in the world, but we're going for 24 hours and running these things absolutely on the limit in the pouring rain at 3 o'clock in the morning after driving for 4 hours when you're trying to overtake a car at 250 mile an hour. It's pretty special, and the fact that we're doing it through the streets of France is just a bit of an added benefit.
Can you tell us a little bit about how you first became aware of the charity and what made you want to get involved yourself?
I actually performed here, not here specifically, but at one of their balls, and this was years ago, and I got to meet some of the children and some of the families that were there, and it just really struck a chord with me. And then ever since then, I've been an ambassador for them, and I've been on trips with them and things like that, and it's just an amazing charity, and actually going away and seeing what they do firsthand and spending the time with the families and seeing that the money raised just goes directly to them and helping them. It's really fantastic. So I always try and come down and support, obviously. They raise money for families and children with disabilities and life-threatening illnesses, and help them with everything, really. So from medicines to equipment that's needed, to support for the families. And the trip that I went on to Florida, to Disney with them, it was just amazing because they really took away everything from the families so that they could just enjoy that time away. They didn't have to worry about how they were going to get all the equipment on the plane or anything like that. It was just really so lovely and really hot. I don't know, it was just very special trip to be on. And so they do amazing work.
Are there any future plans for S Club?
I don't know. 20 years. I was just saying the 20-year reunion will be coming up soon, which I can't believe. And there's been petitions and things going around for a 20-year reunion. So, you know, never know.
Is that something that you and the rest of the band would be up for, given the opportunity?
I mean, again, if it was the right thing, definitely. And I think the others would as well. So, yeah, we'll see. We had such an amazing time last time we did it. It was so good to be back together, and it was exactly what we wanted. And, possibly. I think just seeing all the fans, really, and just, it was so special to be back and being able to relive it again, but doing it in a way that it was a celebration of what we had. We just wanted to do a really, just a real celebration of it all. And it was great being back together, and it was amazing coming to London and performing at Wembley and the O2 and all the venues, because we've done it so many times, and it was great to experience it again, a little bit older, a little bit wiser.
So you got to do some of your own solo stuff. Is solo music something that you think will ever be on the cards for you again?
Yeah, I wouldn't ever rule it out. Who knows? But my little girls are very big fans. It was lovely. That was also lovely, having them sort of to be there while I was performing. That was very special.
Final question. Have you got anything else coming up at the moment? Anything else on the go?
I'm just working on a few passion projects at the moment, which I've wanted to work on, which I've wanted to get off the ground for a while. So that's exciting. Yeah.